Okay guys, so I'm gonna show you how you can actually make this kind of motion blur. So to try to, I'm just trying to keep it easy for you guys. So let's just start by opening up KeyShot 5. So I'm just gonna take this Evo that I have laying around and you can also see there's in the settings there's motion blur. This will enable motion blur on all of the image. Okay, now let's go further. So what we're trying to do is, first of all, we're trying to get this wheel. Centered and focused. Oh god. It's not really good when you have a screencast or anything else on. Shit. Wait. I'm just trying to get it centered. Okay, never mind that. Okay, now it's good. Now, if it were to add like motion to this whole wheel, it would be pretty ugly. At least that's my opinion. But as you can probably see, we have 1, 2, 3, 4 wheels. Each wheel is separate. So, we're trying to figure out which part is which. Steel, yep, we want that. We want that. Brake caliper. We don't want that. We don't want those parts as well. You want the rim and the wheel itself. Okay, with no. The tire. Okay, so make these to a group. Select new group, motion one. So you don't have to do this on every wheel, but just
do it on the parts you actually want to have motion blur. Paint. Anodize, paint. Seal, work, paint. Tire? Just trying to fathom out which part is which. Okay. No. Take these parts. It's kind of slow when you're trying to get all the parts and while you're recording at the same time. Okay, anodized, paint, steel, and work. Chrome, paint. Yeah, should be good. Yep. Now this should be alright. Also add to new group. New group. Motion 2. Okay. So we have motion 1 and motion 2 as groups. Now make them lower. And so when you have motion 1 and motion 2. Now make animation, rotation, x-axis, around like 1200. You don't like me, you just want the attention.
see. Yep, there's the whole rim, and you can actually see the brake caliper stays in place.
Okay, that's what we're trying to have.
Okay, so close that. Now motion two.
Animation. Rotation. Make 1200 degrees. So when you render, actually, it will look kind of blurry. That's what we're trying to achieve. And you can already see it's rendering. That's what we're trying to achieve. And yeah, you want to have it. Okay, we're gonna delete. Just do it in one wheel. Just because I just don't want to mess around with the models. As you already can see this motion happening. So what's really happening is this wheel is turning the same time while the brake caliper stays in place. And everything else is turning. So now trying to achieve is render and in output whatever resolution you want to have. Quality, you cannot have advanced control, only maximum samples or maximum time. I'm going for maximum samples. I'm just gonna render this region and let's render it. So it's gonna take one image, second image. That's basically, it's gonna take a little bit of time, so I'll be back when it's finished. So now it's finished, but as you can probably tell, it's not that specific, but you can actually see it's starting to look like some kind of motion blur. Well, we want to bump up the samples, so the more samples you have, the more quality you will have in the final output. So in the final output, you'll actually have like this. This is what you're trying to achieve. So right now, I set its samples to 2 so it could render faster. But if you have done the old steps that I did, you will have, eventually if you bump up the samples, you will actually have something like this. So this is what you're trying to achieve. So just, wait, I'm gonna close this. So what you're trying to achieve is, yeah, just whatever you need to have that you want a motion blur, like the rim, the caliper, no, not the caliper, but like all the struts and everything inside, just put them in a group and always have one wheel separate. If you have them all under one thing, it will go all around the place. So that's one thing you don't want to have. Just take one model, take all the parts, add them to a group, enable motion blur in settings, mess around with these settings if you want to, environments, whatever, and they will all be adapted. And afterwards, just go into scene, motion, animation, rotation, select the axis you actually wanted to have rotate on for wheels, x-axis. And always set the degrees as maximum as possible. Around 1200, if it seems okay in here, will probably look good in the final render as well. But keep in mind that you want to bump the samples so you will get this kind of effect. And this is the end result that you're trying to have. But this is also like really low quality, but it does the job. So I hope this helped a lot of people, or if it didn't, you can always like hang around with those like settings and select how long the animation will last and everything, so afterwards you know actually which how to play around with it. It's basically a trial and error, but this is the basics that you want to have when you're trying to make motion blur in KeyShot 5.